will write the subheading PKL.
The word infrastructure means something generic. Actually, this consists of all this security certification system, full certification system. Certificates, authority, standards, everything. Together we call it infrastructure. Okay, right? Put this in a box because this is the definition from the syllabus. PKI is the system. Digital certification system of digital certification, comma CA certification authority CA and other registration authorities. Certification authorities that verify and authenticate the validity of each party. involved in an internet transaction. And you can put that policy inside the box. Because the common question in the papers is explain the detail of the team structure. Even if this definition, it is a system of security certification. It will consist of this certification authorities, registration authorities. What are they doing mainly? They are making sure that the parties involved in a transaction are properly identified. The system will know who is transacting with whom. That's the idea. Why is it necessary? Because we want to prevent man in the middle attack. Main idea is that two parties should know each other properly rather than each party certifying himself. There is another party, government authority certifying the identity of the person, it will be better for all transactions. We are not talking about just downloading something from a server, we are talking about services which are going into e-commerce kind of application, electronic transactions. I just read that in a paper, I was in the US today. Like in the US, who became the 560th in the ranking of the world. He is 560th in the world. And he has been tracked down by the US police. Because he has generated his wealth by tapping into electronic transactions. In a particular transaction, he was caught. And really, he gave certain million rupee aid for Sri Lanka for the tsunami. There's a story that President Kumar Singh went there and officially thanked him for the donation.
And now he is arrested because the donation comes from government.
Right, so we are talking about that kind of trust. Somebody must be there to prevent fraud.
There.
Prevent fraud at that level. And so when systems are not strong enough, people will exploit that. You can try. This deeper, but it is necessary. It is necessary.
Because single CA server, because a single CA server cannot, single CA server cannot practically handle, cannot practically handle all certification requests. Therefore, we should have a hierarchy structure like the domain name service.
We should have a hierarchy structure like the domain name service. DNS, domain name service. So, at the top level, there is a root PK.
Root RWT. Root CA. It certifies the performance of CA in the second level. Second level CA certifies third level CA.
Level 3 are called R-Way.
यत्रो वानप्लावे यत्रो वानप्लावे और रजिस्ट्रेशन अथॉरिटी there are many registration authorities under each city. They are called RA. This kind of a tree structure is called TK. And these certification authorities should be in a hierarchy like this. And they must offer certificates in a common form. In the world are in the above are in a hierarchy. Perfect. For verification. We should check the validity period and the digital signature. The next step.
register or they forward the public key to a registration authority in the local area. Only the public key, the blue one, is forwarded to a registration authority. This is similar to you getting identity card from gram cell, right? The server has their own gram cell. They have registered. But this is worldwide gram cell, not local. So what is the RA do? RA is check your personal information, check who is the server, and store that personal information in a database. All the information forwarded, so there is a form to fill. The information from the field form will be double checked by the RA.
Thank you.
के संबंध के बेसिस ऑन द बेस ऑन द मेन यू नेवर डिस्क्लोज इट इज विद यू यू जनरेटेड दैट फी फॉरवर्डेड ओनली दिस 2000 देन ऑथेंटिकेशन कम बैक सर्टिफिकेट इज फॉर दिस दिस इज योर ओन नोबडी नो इट नेवर गोस टू हिम प्राइवेट की नेवर गोस टू हिम That's an important point you must remember. The private key you generated and kept for yourself, you get the certificate only for the public. And this is the PKI, actually, and we have only drawn that part. RSPS. The country.
security measures, to take security measures, example, email, FTP, etc. New line, so email, a digital signature, and encryption are used in combination. Using PGP mechanism. Using PGP mechanism. PGP means pretty good privacy. Pretty good privacy mechanism. Pretty good privacy. So the mechanism they use so that a person can digitally sign the email. So his authentication will be official. So that's the answer. The digitally signed email. The digitally signed email is encrypted with one time secret key. It is like a symmetric key. First bracket, and then that secret key is encrypted. Using the recipient, using the recipient, recipient, public key, comma, as shown below. Mechanism is used, our theory is in combination like this. This is the sender. We are sending digitally signed email. All the theory is studied earlier is still used. This is your email. A hacking algorithm will generate the digest small version of the email, encrypted using your private key. Now you have signed digest gets attached here. Email is in normal text, but signed digest is there. But this is not private now, because anyone can monitor this set. Therefore, it will be encrypted using a one-time secret key. Only for this email, that key will be generated. But then the other one does not have this key. So that key will be encrypted using recipient public key, and then combined with this and that. So first, the recipient using this for private key will have to take this key out. Secret. And then use that to take this and then use this to authenticate and verify. Then all security measures are there. So this is encrypted email. So secure email. So we do. Now you are using two keys, right? Three keys. Your private key, recipient public key, and a one-time secret key. One-time secret key generation, which is a symmetric key algorithm. So again, you are using asymmetric key algorithm, symmetric key algorithm, digital signatures, and encryption. Every technique we discuss are there in the teaching.
compared to our previous diagram, this is a new thing that has come. Earlier we said deep public key will be used encrypted, but now it is not deep public key, it is new key, local generator, and that key will be encrypted and attached to this.
कहना है कि मैं डाइजेस्ट करना, मैं इतना इनक्रिप्ट करना, मैं देखा मतलब मैं मैसेज जगह देता है, देखो मैं इनकी
मैं
इनक्रिप्ट
नहीं मेरे दोनों मत ही ना ठीक है 20 का एक ही लगा 20 का हम ये करो
तेरे को कंबाइन करना
बेटा नहीं मेरे को ये नहीं लगा
दिस कैन बी एनक्रिप्टेड यूजिंग 20 पब्लिक की आर का कंसीडर बट नाउ इट इज नॉट डन इट इज एनक्रिप्टेड यूजिंग द सिमेट्रिक द सिमेट्रिक की जो क्रिप्टेड यूजिंग 20 पब्लिक की अटेंशन करना दैट्स द डिफरेंस इट इज सिमेट्रिक अटेंशन symmetric key will be encrypted by using the asymmetric key. Asymmetric key is the public key of B. And then that's an example of application layer security. Now this security is done by the application layer itself, the email program itself. This security activity activities are carried out by the email program itself. Then next happening, security at network layer level. Security at the network layer level. Security at the network layer level. Network layer is IP layer. ICDF, Internet Engineering Task Force, they came up with a new set of protocols which we call IPsec protocol. IP security protocol. Text is on the same one. IPsec is not a protocol, remember. It is category of protocols. Under that there are security protocols here. And these protocols modify the internet packets to IP. As some new fields actually. For transmission. So if you need security not at the application layer, but at the network layer, when you enter the packets into the network, you can implement IPsec. Right? You can write. IETF, Internet Engineering Task Force, IETF,
has defined the collection of protocols known as IPsec. To provide security at IP packet level. Provide security at IP packet level. But IPsec does not define any specific encryption method
just a method for a mechanism rather than set procedure. Therefore, he provides only a framework and the mechanism. Framework and the mechanism. Underlying lesson is what he provides only a framework and a mechanism. New paragraph. The mechanism is the mechanism is to form a security association. Security association. Between the sender and the recipient. Security association between the sender and the recipient. Underline security association. So this association means you inform the two parties, okay, you are now secure. But it could be unidirectional or bidirectional. That means both ways you can secure, or only one way you can secure. That also means the security association can be unidirectional or bidirectional. Can be unidirectional or bidirectional. It should be established for each direction separately. It should be established for each direction separately. Security association means a kind of a connection, secure connection. So that means the two parties should identify each other, authenticate each other. And the authentication method is, it needs three elements. When you want to authenticate, it's not at this level now. When you want to authenticate, it needs three things. One is the protocol element. There are two protocols to choose from. If you are a user, IP user, you can choose one of the two protocols. And it is your choice. But both are okay. And there is a special number called SPR. That also you have to select. And the third one is your source. So those three are known as three elements of security. Three elements of security associated. Number called SPI, then protocol, IP then protocol, color code is one element. Number two, IPsec protocol. IC is C capital, then E and C is IC check. IC check,
reserve for us.
Then let us select one of the two methods. Select one of the two. Number three, the source IP address. Source IP address. New paragraph, he said there are two IP check protocols, he'll mention their name. New paragraph. The two IP check protocols available are देख लो ठीक से की लाइफ भी कट गई है अदर थिंग्स आर पॉसिबल लाइक ऑथेंटिकेशन डेटा इंटीग्रिटी जो सब पॉसिबल बट ठीक से देख ना तो जब टाइम से ठीक से की इज नॉट अवेलेबल ठीक से की प्राइवेट ठीक से की ओरिजिनल प्राइवेट तो प्राइवेट इज नॉट अवेलेबल
Then companies will find it's not worth the investment. You have invested, finally find that people are still are confused. If you ask the people only, you will know what is their worry. They will say, my worry is secret. Most of the time, that is the answer. They come and ask, okay, we know that it's a modern technique you have discovered, but is it secure? That's correct. So new methods are coming, and at each layer, difficulty might come. And not only these two layers, but these two layers are the ones which are having the difficulty introduced. At the moment, integrated security may be more costly than incremental security. Sometimes you think of security only when they realize that integrated security can cause more problems. Till then, there is nothing. There is not good security now. It's like lightning. Lightning might damage your equipment once in a year. The damage may be, let us say, 50,000 rupees. But the lightning protection system, if you install, it may be 100,000 rupees. Could you install? And the protection system says there is no 100% guarantee. There is a certain percentage of protection. These security systems are also like that. There is no 100% guarantee that someone will not tap. But if you try to prevent, but you will need investment. And you will invest only if the damage caused due to a security breach is more than what you invest. Otherwise, you will not invest. The same logic here. Same logic in the situation here. Okay. Next, you see how a company, what are the methods available to protect a company from being attacked? Can write something in privacy at the organization level. Privacy at organization level. Normally, what is the method you use to protect organization? You put a firewall. Firewall is a technique. And the firewall may be trying to analyze the packets and see whether they are valid ones or authorized ones or not. And there are different types of firewalls. Some firewalls operate at the application layer level. That means it will monitor the application layer header and identify certain applications and prevent them from coming into the company or going out of the company. Some firewalls will not look at the application level, they will look at the other criteria like IP address from where it is coming, port address, various things like not port address, IP address, it is the source, not the application, but anything coming from that source, for it. So that kind of security can also be having, that's called catastrophic firewall. You will be mentioned, company has the option of. But firewall is not the only one, but very common one is the firewall. Company firewall under that. This is a device that comes between the company intranet.
Like a gate. and program different criteria to eliminate hackers. I will be like that.
Divert
फूल
स्थिति की कटर स्थिति की टॉक्सिक विच ओपन दिस पैकेट open this packet at application level. At application level and find out whether the request is legitimate. Whether the request is legitimate. If not, they are discarded. Good sir. If yes, proxy will now act as a client. Proxy will now act as a client and forward the request to the HTTP server. Server in the intranet. This way, the server is protected from attack. So those are the two modes of firewall for the website. In the second mode, in the mode we just discussed, the idea is the server will not be directly replying to the request coming from outside internet. Because then someone can easily attack the server. We are talking about company server. So what we do is we divert all the requests coming from the server into another proxy firewall. Proxy firewall will open it up, analyze, and find whether it is a valid or legitimate request according to some criteria you program. And if it is identified like that, it will forward the request to the server. Now that proxy becomes the client now. Proxy becomes the client, request will come to the server, server will reply to the proxy, proxy will reply to the external client. So proxy is always coming in the middle between the external party and the server, therefore server is better protected. So company servers which carry vital information, you might be protecting by that kind of a proxy, which is the application level proxy, not packet filtering type one. It is not only filtering packets, you can see it is opening and then analyzing and after that closing the packet and sending the packet as if it is the client. So reply will come to it and then it will go. So that way it is safer. Remember these are the two methods available with the proxy. Simple proxy will do packet filter. But if a critical server is there in the company and you can't allow it to be attacked, you can think of proxy firewalls as well. Okay. Next. There are three ways you can protect your network. Company network. One method is the most simple, first method. First method is you never open it up for the internet. You can still have network. Your company may have many branches in the country and you can network all over. But you keep the internet away. It's your internal network part. That can be a true intranet because you are not connecting up. And the lines you are using to connect your branches will be all these lines. These lines will give you better protection. But they will be costly. So High cost of lead line. So this is an expensive method. Two, internet access not available. Second method is to establish hybrid communication.
Hybrid communication. Here you will have public internet here. Public internet. And you will put another router like this and connect to public internet router. Each branch can do. These links you keep actually for your internal coming. These links you use for internet. This is for the hybrid. These are for internal communication. So that way all your internal communication, they never go through the internet, therefore your internal communications are safe. software and connect to the internet. But company communications are not channeled through the internet, they are channeled through the these lines.
This is overcome the first disadvantage. Sorry, second disadvantage, not the first part. That is the second disadvantage, no internet access. That can be overcome. But lead time is still there. So high cost of lead time will be still a problem. And that is why virtual private networks came to be. That's the third service. Number three, VPN. The method virtual private network. ISP, Internet Service Provider, shall create a virtual network
for the company.
Carry out its internal communication.
Yeah, for it's called VPN. Virtual plus private. Virtual plus private. Yeah, for virtual private network. Yeah, for it's called VPN. One disadvantage is now the company will have to subdivide its IP address frame for all the branches. Because now whole thing is going via the internet.
Yeah. Okay. However, the address frame available to the company, address frame available to the company should be subdivided. Subdivided between its branches. Between its branches.
So IPsec for the technology we studied there, this is how it is used. The technology IPsec, it is a framework actually, framework and methodology, and that will be used to create VPN. So using the internet, ISPs can program multiple VPNs for different clients, different companies. That way, company will be benefited. ISPs will also be benefited. ISPs get some additional income, company gets a cheaper service. With sufficient security, you can guarantee that you will not be attacked. The chances of attack are minimized. So you are sacrificing certain amount of security now, but the cost is now low rather than having your own clean plan. It's a compromise. According to our syllabus, we should know IPsec as a technology, and also we should know where it is being used. This is where it is being used. Out of the three methods, the VPN method is using IPsec. But are other two? Fully private network, hybrid network, VPN. VPN network is using the IP server. And out of the three methods, VPN networks have become very popular because of the cost effectiveness. Okay, let's talk about the security we have to look at. Let us summarize what are the things we studied first. We first studied there are four requirements of security. If you have to secure communication, you have to secure the secrecy. And then integrity of the message, then non-repudiation, okay, then authenticate, the identity of the person who is sending. Identity is not enough. You can get the identity first, but later he might deny. Therefore, you have to have a record somewhere so that he can't later say no. That's called non-repudiation. So all these four requirements. Then you found that cryptography will help us to ensure secret, but will not help in any of the other three requirements. If we introduce digital signatures, all other three will be properly covered, but secrecy cannot be ensured. So the technique we practice should have a combination of cryptography and digital signatures. Yes, cryptography and digital signatures. Then all four is covered. And we saw the PGP, pretty good privacy, we saw in the email, it uses all these things. It's a real application, it uses all the things. And then we noted that it is not possible to be safe from the middle attack, man in the middle attack.
to minimize that chance, you need a PKI, public key infrastructure, where some guardian is, some authority will have to certify this public key. So then you are sure that that public key belongs to that person. So that kind of certification authority worldwide is required, and that arrangement is called PKI. X519 also is supporting that by giving a common format for all setups. And then each user and each server, that means the client and the server, is supposed to store these setups. And in the future, we always have to, because if you are using internet for commercial purposes, if you are a user also, you will have to get the certificate. You have to get the key. And certificate is for a period, and after that you have to reapply, and for that there is a fee. So there is a regular cost for certifying yourself. Otherwise other people will be afraid to communicate with you because you have not secured your identity. It's like you are a person having a without an identity card. Every time the checkpoint stops you, they are suspicious. You don't want that to happen, therefore in the future we all might need to get those certificates. As individual. At the moment it's server, but when more and more activities come on the internet, users will need authenticate and certificate. After that we discussed this part where the firewalls can protect us, and also we learn three methods, private, hybrid, VPN. We learn VPN, this we apply this network level security. Not the application level, but network level security. Application level security will be applied to other techniques like that we discussed as PGP. So that's the summary. But security is a huge area. There are full courses or semesters on security. There are full MSc courses on computer security. What we could do was just kind of understanding what are the basic measures that we can take. But these measures are not enough for today's application. The new techniques are being developed now. It's a big research area, computer security and network security is a big research area. You have that idea in the mind, at the back of your mind, because security is going to become a major area in the future. And so if they do a syllabus change, next, there will be a big section on computer security, I'm sure about it. In the universities it is happening. So that, what does that mean? That means the world is becoming insecure. That is what it means. Otherwise, why do people worry so much about security? So we will stop at that point. Right? Next time we can start on Canvas, which is a small new topic. We can finish it in one day.